Quetico Superior Forest extends for almost 200 miles along the international border from Lake Superior to Lake of the Woods. Once the route of the colorful and intrepid French voyagers, fortunes and fur came down its beautiful waterways. Explorers traveled through it in their long search for the Northwest Passage. Today, thousands of modern voyagers explore it, paddle down the lakes traversed by the adventurers of the past, and pack over the ancient portages that once felt only the tread of moccasined feet. Here, people not only breathe the spirit of the past, but experience a scene that is practically unchanged from the days of discovery. Show you boat bag that comes with us. It sits in the very back of the boat to balance out the weight. And in there, I've got now I'm in one of my very favorite places in the world. Beautiful boulder, granite boulder. It sticks out right in the middle of Kawnipi Lake. It's normally a walleye magnet. Not so much today, but we'll see. It's a little early yet. May still, you know. Kind of cushioned, stuck in the middle on a nice bush. And as I sit here, I gaze around me and I think, you know, there's no place else I'd rather be. Just ran into this wonderful couple who are on a 21-day trip. And look, at they've got the gear for it, they're ready. And what a unique oar situation you had.
That's from Spring Creek Outfitters out of Mountain. We're cruising at 5'6".
Are you really?
You just watch.
I'm gonna film you as you leave. So you flew in, landed on clay.
We came down the Greenwood River, then we got on the Wywag. And the amount of wildlife on the Wywag is the highest concentration of wildlife I've ever seen anywhere.
I saw at least a 5-foot bear from its head to its tail swimming across.
It looked like, we thought it was a moose.
I thought it was a young moose. Tell you that I caught a 40-inch
snorkel. Yeah, she caught more fish than I have. She caught a 21-inch smallmouth.
That's a 5-pounder.
Yeah.
And I caught a 20-inch smallmouth, and then she caught a 19.5-inch smallmouth. So those are kind of the highlights.
Those are beauties. Oh, yeah. Nice. So here's Bo getting ready to get into the propeller seat there. I've seen serious educators, dignified surgeons, congressmen, and admirals tie up their heads in gaudy bandanas, go shirtless to bring on the tan of the northern sun, and wear bowie knives in their belts. I've seen them glory in the muck of portages, fight the crashing combers on stormy lakes with the abandon of boys on their first adventure. I've heard them laugh as they haven't laughed for years and bellow old songs in the teeth of a gale. With their newfound freedom and release, many things become important that were half forgotten. Sunsets, the coloring of clouds and leaves, reflections in the water. Men laugh and sing as naturally as breathing once the strain is gone.
Wow, that's quick already.
Okay, here we are, coming in, fully loaded boat here from fishing, trying to keep those walleyes alive, but not looking good. I might have to have an early dinner tonight. Got that one there, just won't kick down.
So here is a walleye steak gumbo on Paradise Island in the bug-free zone. The island of Paradise out here in Kawnipi. This is my first time back in 3 years. And it's interesting because a lot of the places where I used to frequent have grown over. Really very little traffic here. You can tell that few people have been here, and just getting settled in with my new outfit. Everything's miniaturized, lighter, faster. So for sure, the new boat has definitely increased my range, speed. So the challenges are definitely there, and I'm taking it really slow and easy so that I can incrementally work my way into being comfortable. 14 foot, 22 pound, 25 inch beam pack canoe. Really, it's a kayak with an open deck. And I'll show you how we pack this thing up. So up front here, in the very front, in the tip, we've got our waders, which we haven't needed this whole trip. Face mask for swimming. And then underneath there is camera bag with GoPro, DSLR cameras, batteries, recharging equipment. And then this pack here, cook gear, stoves, first aid, jet boil. And then we keep our tackle pack here. And this is our, I call it my man bag. Accessory pack, all kind of emergency stuff in there, necessities. And you'll notice that the tackle pack is secured here and the man bag is secured here to this D-ring. Here's my leash. I actually strap myself in every time I go somewhere. I've got a cord on my web belt that I lash into. Because if you ever lose this boat, if you ever fall out in a big open lake with wind, you are not gonna catch up. This big pack is where most of the weight is, and that's tent, sleeping bags, air mattresses, and fuel, stakes, and bungee cords for all the tents. And then finally in the very back here, in this pack, we have our bear vault wrapped with the screen house. And then in the very back here, I've got personal hygiene kit on the bottom and then a bag of garbage on top, which I carry as just an extra item. So there it is. And then we've got our foot braces right here for balance. And as you can see, it's very tight. No space to spare. And riding a little over the gunwale back here, no other choice. Thank you. There is a fierce satisfaction that only comes with hardship, fighting the waves. A heavy pack. Canoe. Setting up camp after a bone-wearying day, and then sleeping on the ground. May not always be fun, but nevertheless are for many people a stress-releasing break from a comfortable yet vaguely unsatisfying urban life.
Here's the senior resident of the neighborhood right here. Look at this. A little group of them. You got one here. Finally, time to go climb the lookout tree. Hello, Mr. Big. All we gotta do is get up a little ways, and there's a smooth path all the way, as we saw from the ground. Of course, we're not anticipating any lightning. It's a little crowded up there to go any higher. Don't want to go down. Spend all day up here. What a view. Of course, we've always got an arm wrap. Always 2 points of anchor.
Since this pack canoe is really a kayak in disguise, I had to change my footwear, because one cannot be a dry booter when you have to enter the boat butt first. So I brought a warm and cold weather alternative. Although I normally prefer covered shoes, I discovered too late that mine were damaged. So I ended up substituting sandals, which worked out fine for colder situations. Given the wet foot requirement, along with the possibility of sitting in a puddle, I bring along a pair of ultralight waders, although I didn't need them on this trip. These would be combined with Sims wading / hiking boots. They're designed to grip the slippery bottom while supporting your ankles for weight-bearing activities. They drain and dry quickly and protect your feet. The other pair of shoes are Gore-Tex trail runners.
We've been wearing all the summer sun protective clothing. Now it's time to change over and put on some warm clothing.
Under Armour. Real tree. Long sleeve. Insulated boxer shorts on. And then a pair of winter Columbia pants. And then on top of those two long sleeve silk garments, do over this to protect this from tears, is I wear my spare wind shirt, which is really what I keep around for camp. And lots of big pockets, compartments, wind resistant, blocks the sun, and then protects that down vest so that I don't have to worry about rips and tears. Well, here we are getting some weather. So here it is, about
6:20 on Thursday morning. Thursday's the day the guys are flying in, so sometime this morning we should hear their airplane. Also today, we're going to have a special treat. One of my former videos, a few years ago, I started at Beaver House, and I utilized transportation from the very first outfitter I ever had up here, which was Canoe Canada Outfitters out of Atticoken for the first decade or so. I used to use these guys, and they had the trapping rights to this territory. So I get in the car with Bud Dixon. We're driving from the pickup point over to Beaver House, and he tells me that he still has those trapping rights, and he has a trapping cabin right here on Kawnipi in the vicinity. So naturally, I asked him to mark it on my map. Now here I am about 5 years later with that map, and I'm camped really close to it. So I'm going to go check out that trapper cabin today. Hopefully we can bring you that footage. Okay, I found the trapper's cabin. It's right here. Ah, what a shame. It all came down. Ugh. Now look at these traps. Here's the inside. Kitchen window. Here's the shoes. Here's the bunk. Sleeping bag. I'm gonna get out of here before it falls on me. To give you a feel for what it's like here. Happy, happy, happy. Into our bug-free zone. Love this greenhouse. Bungee yoke. It slides right on there, stays on, and it's easy to snap onto your gear when you're moving around from lake to lake. Jet boil. This thing is so quick, so easy. Takes about 2 minutes. Activated water filtration. The bear vault. This thing is revolutionary in my world. So what it enables you to do is store all your aromatic consumables in a watertight, crush-proof, tamper-proof container that the bears cannot penetrate. Instead of climbing a tree with rope,
And to get it open, just use a credit card. Very restricted diet. I was a army paratroop, and through the course of that activity, I developed some real hip issues that required surgery on both sides. So I have to be especially careful up here about dislocating a hip, because what I'm trying to do is get down to the root cause of some very bad pain issues to maintain a diet that is non-inflammatory. Pemmican. As a backup protein source to fish, powdered eggs provide an alternative. I combined other elements of the food pack to create delicious omelets. These grass-fed beef sticks. Baby bell cheese. Instant coffee. Electrolyte drinks. So, gonna get up in the morning and head in to meet the guys. Definitely heard their planes this morning, right around 9 o'clock. It all began 2 years ago, on a trip from Crane Lake to Prairie Portage. I met these guys on the transport boat en route to Lac La Croix. We instantly connected due to our shared enthusiasm for canoe country. I visited their campsite and was amazed at the resort-like accommodations they'd created through the application of mostly custom-made equipment. Fast forward to this past winter, and Dave reaches out to advise that he will be at his favorite spring campsite, not far from Kawnipi, at the same time that I'll be there. These guys are all tournament bass fishermen who discovered this wilderness, and I don't think I've ever in all my years encountered anybody that's got a better handle on the fishing in terms of being able to catch the fish, but also documenting their results.